my amazing brother got arrested 4 weeks ago. The security forces in Iran put him in handcuffs, in blindfold, and arrested him in front of his two small children. His crime? Being my brother. My crime? Being a woman, loud against oppression. This is called hostage taking. They want to keep me silent. And that is why they went after my brother to punish me. But the government of Iran don't know me well, because I'm not going to be silent only the day that I'm dead. That is why I am here today with you. I'm a child of revolution, and I know those hostage takers. Before the revolution, we, the women in Iran, we had female judges, we had female ministers, we had female singers. We were allowed to sing, to dance, to show our hair. But after the revolution, we had to fight for every single right. Women were banned from dancing. Women were banned from singing. We don't have female judges in Iran. We don't have female ministers in Iran. So basically, the Islamic revolution has failed, became a revolution against women. Recently, a young woman, Sahar Khodayari, known as Blue Girl, she sneaked into a stadium, dressing like a boy. She wanted to be free and enjoy. What happened? She got arrested. As soon as she found out that she has to go to prison for 6 months, she killed herself. She set herself on fire and she died. This is how Iranian women in 21st century fighting for their basic rights. But for me, as a little girl in a tiny village, I never had a clue about discrimination. I never had a clue about feminism, equality. All I knew, I had a brother. He doesn't look like a criminal. Again, my brother Ali. But in the village, he was the king of the day in the village. Why? Because he was allowed to do whatever he wanted. He was allowed to jump in a beautiful river in my village. He was allowed to sing, to go out, to go to stadium, to play with boys around in the street in his shorts. All the freedom that I wanted, but I was banned because I was a girl. So what I had to do to gain my right back from my family's house, my mother, who is not even able to read and write, but trust me, she is the true feminist in Iran. She taught me a lesson, how to fight for my rights. I grew up in a very poor family. We didn't have running water, no electricity, no even indoor bathroom. We had outhouse in the backyard garden. During the night, it was dark. It was pitch black. Imagine, as a little girl, I had to go to outhouse every night. It was blacker than black, if such a thing is possible. But my mom taught me a lesson. My true teacher told me, darkness is like a monster. If you're scared of the darkness, then the darkness can devour you. The darkness can swallow you whole. Instead of being scared of the darkness, stare into the darkness. Open your eyes as wide as you can. Then the darkness will disappear. As a kid, I thought this is a fact. So I used to open my eyes as wide as I could. It worked. It worked. This is how I learned to fight against the darkness. And guess what? I was the one my brother need to lead on me, rely on me. Because the king of the village was scared of the darkness. And he had to ask me to take him to outhouse. You know what I did? I said, okay, but if you need my help, to fight against the darkness during the night, then you have to be my ally during the day to fight against the darkness and take me wherever you go and I'm banned. This is how you take your freedom from men in society, in country like Iran. I said, then you have to take me to ride a bicycle. You have to take me to a stadium. You have to take me to the river. This is because we, the women in Iran and in the Middle East, we face a lot of darkness. And through our pain, we have to be powerful and we have to find our allies. And Ali became my allies. And I started, like many other women in the Middle East, my revolution from this kitchen. For me, compulsory hijab was a form of darkness which designed to censor women, to make us invisible, to put us behind the curtain, which I couldn't accept that. As you see, there is a chair. The sink was low because the kitchen was designed for women, for my mother, who was shorter than my father. I found a chair and I said to my brother, sit down and wash the dishes and stay with me. This is how we have to fight and for our every single right. And I got expelled from everywhere just because of that. I was a naughty teenager, so I got expelled from high school just because of asking too many questions. And then in my second school, I joined a group spreading pamphlets against the government. This time, not only getting expelled, but I was in jail because of criticizing the government. As soon as they found that I was pregnant in prison, then they let me free. But that didn't stop me. I became a parliamentary journalist, and I exposed the corruption in Iranian parliament. I published their pay slips, the salaries, the bonus, all the money the MP have been paid to themselves. And I got expelled from Iranian parliament because of that. Believe me, if any journalist does this in the West, they receive an award. And my reward was being kicked out from Iranian parliament. As you see, I got expelled from everywhere. And my mom used to tell me, when my father, I was a naughty girl, when my father locked me out from a room, I was able, as my mom said, to find a window to sneak back to the same room. At the end, they expelled me from my homeland, from my beloved Iran. And I had to look for a window to get back, to sneak back to my homeland. So social media is my window. And I'm there every day. My eyes are there. My heart is there. I took my country on my shoulder. And I take it everywhere to talk about brave women of Iran. Shahnaz, her son got killed, shot in the head during the demonstration in 2009 in Iran, where he just joined a peaceful demonstration. They killed more than 100 people, but they never had a chance to talk in Iranian media. Her mother became a voice. She started to film herself and send the video to me. She went town by town to find other mothers who lost their beloved one. And that is how I became the storytellers of 57 people who got killed. The government denied the killings. But believe me, when you have a camera and when you have a voice, nobody can deny you. When you overcome your fear, then you're not a victim anymore. You are a warrior like Shahnaz. And we have many warriors like Shahnaz in Iran. So the camera and her story told me another lesson, that I have to talk about other women. One day, I just published a picture of myself running in a beautiful street full of blossoms in London. And I wrote a simple caption. The caption was that anytime when I run in a beautiful, you know, free country and I feel the wind in my hair, it just reminds me of the time when my hair was like a hostage in the hand of Iranian government. I received a lot of comments from Iranian women envying at my freedom from compulsory hijab. I said, wait a minute. I found another picture of myself, this time taken inside Iran, driving unveiled. And I wrote a new caption. I said, I know there are millions of Iranian women. They have the same pictures. They know how to bypass the authorities and create the moment of freedom that they want. Would you want to share it with me? That was the question. And I was bombarded by photos, videos, beautiful photos of women holding their headscarf like a flag of freedom. The government called this flag of prostitution. But believe me, show me if you agree, this is a flag of freedom. Women are holding their flag like this in public and walking unveiled. This is a punishable crime, but women know the risk and they want to protest against one of the most important pillars of gender apartheid. They know that they might get arrested, but this is the only way that they want to be heard. They can get lashes, they can get kicked out, but they do it because they know that freedom has a price and they are ready to pay the price. The street was not enough for these women. And they went beyond White Wednesdays. They went beyond my selfie freedom. They were fearless. They jumped on a utility box in Iran. I'm sure that you saw that, no? Women put the headscarf on a stick and waved it in public. I think you have white headscarf with you, no? This is a simple act of protest. Today is White Wednesdays in Iran. Today is the day when women get arrested if they do this. Why? Because they're trying to tell the government that this is 21st century and I am a woman and this is my body, my choice. This is 21st century and nobody can make decisions for me. We want to tell the government that do not write your ideology on my body. And for that, women get arrested. Six women. They are in prison, and all of them, they received altogether a combined prison sentence, 109 years. Can you believe that? This is not numbers. These are not statistics. They have to spend their lives in prison. They have names. Sabah Kordafshari, 20 years old, 24 years prison. Yasaman Aryani, 24 years. 16 years prison. Her mother, Munira Arab Shahi, 16 years prison. Mojgan Keshavarz, a mother of 9-year-old girl, 23 years prison. Matin and Maryam, sisters, each received 15 years prison. But what bothers me are the female politicians, the leaders of the world from free country who goes to my beautiful country. They obey compulsory hijab laws without even challenging discriminatory law. They don't even dare to ask a simple question about compulsory hijab. Guess why? They say hijab is required by law. We don't want to break the law. Come on. Slavery used to be legal. If no one objected against slavery, nowadays slavery could have been with us. They say, we want to respect the culture of Iran. You kidding me? Calling a discriminatory law part of our culture? This is an insult to a nation. They say, this is an internal matter. We don't want to save Iranian women. I don't want you to save us. We the women of Iran want to save you. Stand up for your dignity. Be as brave as Iranian women. When you go to Iran, challenge the law. They say we don't want to touch compulsory hijab issue because we don't want to cause Islamophobia. Phobia is an irrational fear. But my fear about Sharia laws is rational because I'm not allowed to be my true self in 21st century. And when these leaders go to my beautiful country and they don't challenge the discriminatory law, they empowering the Islamic regime to put more pressure on us. Nowadays, the dictators are more united than us. The dictators from Russia, China, Turkey, Islamic Republic. When democracies crumble, human rights curtailed, freedom of press limited. What we need to show our solidarity and get united, because the only way that we can be successful is to not forget our sisters who risk their lives and they are in prison and support them rather than empowering the government of Iran. The only thing that can help us to be successful and win the battle is be united. Together, we are stronger. Thank you so much.